Scrape, scrape.
Yo, that shit sound good.
Hey, that shit sound good.
you searching for fame. Damn. I became a superstar in the dirt gang. Found out you a hater. I can't look at you the same. Goddamn. She said, can she take...
Peekaboo. Hold on. Is this YouTube?
Billions. Strong. Strong Deans. Today's video, I actually wanted to do the rich life of Strong Villains. But, you know, I want to do it based on my preferences. I wouldn't want to... Sometimes these guys, when they do a rich life of such and such, it's being told by another person that's not the person, which I don't get. But I'm basically going to do my intake on my rich life on... I'm not even rich. I can't even say that. I don't know. But I'm going to take your little taste of, you know, what I, my purchases and what I have and what I spent all my money on. Damn. I have a spending problem. But anyways, let's go. Let me take you on a tour. Let's go.
Right now. Oh, toes out, hoes out.
This is the room, guys. Basically, all the stuff that I have. Ooh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, Yeezy. We got Kobe. We got a whole lot of...
I still got my PS4 box to this day. I don't even know why I still got it, but still here.
My TV here, you know. I don't really watch TV like that, but I only mainly use the TV for, like, you know, the PS4 and whatnot. You know, the PS4 usually sit right here, but my little brother, he had them moved in and put in the living room or some shit. I don't know why, but I guess, I don't know. The bed, basic bed, nothing really, nothing serious. Here, I probably call it the office. You know, this is where I do all my stuff, like, you know, editing. For you guys, of course. You know, I have two laptops. This one was original, but you know, I had to let her retire, so I had to get a new one, of course. This one, you know, didn't want to go big or go home and buy a MacBook, but the MacBook's gonna come soon. Just, you know, hold up on that. It works perfectly like a MacBook too, but you know, I have the AirPods, the speakers when I want to funk, the legendary wallet full of air. You know, my car keys right over here. That's probably gonna show you that to the end of the video. Work binder, but not work binder, but you know, school binder, of course. Take notes or whatnot. Oh, I had bought this. Oh shit, I had bought this the other day. It's a Bluetooth converter to my car. Apparently, the one my radio wasn't really much. It's complicated. I'll show you. And later on in the video, but this is the office. It's gonna be a big office sooner or later, you know,
the closet tour.
Let's start off with up here, a Louis Vuitton wallet. My uncle actually gave me this. I never really wear it because I'm like, too big, like what am I gonna do with it? And plus it's like, you know, I appreciate it. That's why I hold it to this day, you know. I didn't wanna, you know, hey uncle, I don't, you know, want your hand-me-down. You gotta be appreciative of what you got. You get what I mean? Ah, this baby right here. Fendi. It's actually pronounced Fendi. But this is probably one of my favorite belts. I rarely wear it though. I rarely wear it. One of my favorite sleek cream belts. I actually bought it, I think, a year and a half ago. Probably one of my first designer belts that I have actually bought. I wear it occasionally. It has to be certain outfits that I wear, but this one is my baby right here. Oh my god, look at let me unbox it for you. Ooh-wee, look at this. Oh my god, look at this, look at this shine. But this is Salvatore Ferragamo. This is probably one of my, like, I don't even care. You offer me tens and thousands of belts, I'm taking this one any day of the year. I wear this belt
practically anytime I'm trying to look good. You get what I mean? The envelope that it came in. The dust bag. I don't know why I don't even use the dust bag. The dust bag just basically sits in there. I should use it, but I don't like using it. But I'm gonna set her off right here. My cologne section. This is probably my favorite part of the closet. I don't even care. Gentlemen, key advice. If you want to attract a female, my friend, my acquaintance, my wonderful colleague, you have to smell good. If you look good, you cannot come up to her and smell terribly. Once she take a whiff of you and you smell like straight up, I'm not even gonna overdo it. The girls don't even like the scent of weed, to be honest. They probably love weed itself, but the scent of weed, if you're gonna smell like straight up gas, it's gonna be downgraded for you. She's just gonna look at you as the plug. But if you come up to her smelling like Gucci, my friend, oh, you're gonna be Gucci. I keep the boxes just in case, you know, if I wanna rebuy it, I have them here. Gucci, no, this is 777 VIP men. We have Gucci right here. Another Gucci. This one's my favorite Gucci Guilty. I have to restock on this because it's practically finished. My Givenchy. I actually bought two. I fell in love with the first one, and I was like, man, I have to go back and buy a second one, because every time when a girl passed me, I'm like, oh my god, you smell so good. I had to buy it. It's one of my favorites. I'm not too much of a fan of wearing jewelry, but you know, when I do, I try my best. Don't think I'm not gonna come in and just claim, oh my god, this is real, 100% gold. No, I can't do that. Not yet. This is obviously top of the notch gold plated. I actually paid $120 for it, and I paid this one. I actually love this one. Let me just bring it out for you guys. Hold on. We paid a whopping $450 on this baby right here. This is, as you can see, I know you see it dancing. I know you do, but I paid a lot for this one right here. No, not, you know, rapper chain, but I'm not too much of a jewelry guy, but you know, I try my best, you know. Not gonna be a disclaimer and be like, oh my gosh, I wear all this jewelry and stuff. No, I can't do none of that. Some shades that I had bought online for my prom pictures. I call them the Quavos, whatnot. I don't wear them at all. I just keep them here. I don't even know why. I only paid what, like, freaking $5 for these? Anyways. I had bought... Okay, story of this is really, really funny. I actually had bought a pair of AirPods, and I thought that I lost my first pair within a week. Turns out the AirPods was in my pants. But I didn't know that. So the next day, I was freaking out, man. I was like, oh my god, somebody stole my AirPods. But turns out, like, it was in my house the whole time. So I basically went the next day, because if you own AirPods, you don't know how useful these actually are. If you don't have the headphones and you want to charge your phone and listen to music at the same time, because Apple want to be a dick and remove that, but we're not gonna get to that. But these were so useful that I was like, man, I gotta get me another pair, which I actually bought another one. And a week later, as I was doing laundry, I was like, wait, why do I feel this bulge in my pants? And it was my AirPods. So I actually have two AirPods. I gave the other one to my mom because she was like, oh baby, let me have one. And I was like, all right, whatever, mom. So I gave the other pair to my mom, but I ended up buying two AirPods within a week or so. Oh, don't want to get too in depth. Oh, can't give you too much of a in depth of the don't want to do none of that yet. I want y'all to see the drip when I wear it on the camera, but you know, but the shoes, that's probably going to be your favorite part. Let me show you some of the shoes that I have. I'm gonna set up the camera somewhere over here. Favorite part of the video, showing off the shoes. Let me start off. I actually never wore them yet. I plan on wearing them, but I have to actually find an outfit, because finding a color for this is probably
I'm making it hard, but finding a outfit for this, I'm not yet. I have to think something through. But these I plan on wearing very, very soon. When I'll probably be at somebody's birthday party or something, or, you know, on a date with probably somebody special. A wink, wink. 700s. My Yeezers. That's what I call it. But these pairs, I wore these a couple of times. These are one of my favorite pairs of shoes in my closet, actually. I wore these a couple of times, probably 2-3 times. You know, because they're very comfortable, and finding an outfit for these is actually not too hard because most of my closet contains these colors, but I wore them a couple of times. I probably would stop wearing because they crease easily. But you know how Kanye with these shoes. These right here are my babies. I wear these a lot. To a point I even show them a lot. Like, this probably is gonna be a second time in my YouTube video. You'll probably see it more times. But man, these babies do everything. The reason why I probably love them so much, one, they're black. Two, they look practically new. Like, they ain't even much wear them like that unless you're a sneakerhead and be like, hey bro, I see one little crease, bro. You wear them too much. Obviously, Susan meant to be crease, but man, these are my babies and I love them so much. I plan on wearing them plenty of times. If I'm gonna buy something, I have to wear it. Why not? 350s. I need to get them washed because buying white shoes came with something that, you know, when you buy white shoes, they get dirty pretty fast. But I need to find somebody. If y'all know somebody that cleans shoes perfectly, y'all let me know, anything like that. But these, one of my favorite 350s. I plan on buying other pairs, but the colorway, it gotta match but it gotta catch my attention. Obviously, find them when they drop out in black, in the 350s, any sort of black, these shoes go crazy, and the price range is ridiculous. I'm not gonna show the Gucci, because my birthday coming up, and I can't really show y'all the drip like that. But to be honest, truth be told, is that my biggest and favorite purchase? Is it the shoes? Nah, let me show y'all my best and probably one of my favorite purchases that I showed you. Come on, guys. Let's go outside. Y'all know I had to come out here and show you my sexy little, my Speed Racer. Oh, my baby. Woo-wee. Let me stop playing. This is probably one of my favorite, my unforgettable purchases that I actually purchased with my hard-earned money. Can't even say my mom, my dad, my aunt, none of that. Nobody helped me purchase this car, and that was probably one of my main goals that I had to, you know, that I had to acquire. Let me take y'all inside. I plan on... Oh shit, I didn't even unlock the door. I am smoking crack. Anyways, I plan on customizing. I'm gonna get new seats and everything. Sit down real quick. I'm gonna change some of the wheels and whatnot. But a little two-seater, a little back, you know, if I like you, sit back there. My sunroof. I go out to the beach. I didn't even let y'all hear how she sound. Oh my god, let me make sure. Oh, hold on a second. No, y'all heard that. Sounds sexy. But
that is the end of our lovely video for today. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, share this video with y'all peoples, with y'all little brothers, with y'all little sisters, all that. Should be dropping another video. Who knows? Let me stop playing because I've been really slacking YouTube and I cannot be affording to do that. But I'm here, you guys. As y'all can see, I'm ready to go take a spin and I gotta go run a few errands. But I ought to show y'all the fun part about this car. Yeah, hold on. Okay. I gotta wait for it to pop up. Take some time. Oh, there you go. Rise, my king. Rise. Ooh, stop playing. But YouTube, let me get going and twos.